In the previous, previously I said that the synchronous machine having the field on the rotor and the armature on the stator means rotor is actually having the field and my stator is actually having the armature. So this arrangement is normally used for synchronous machine. One may ask why, what is the reason behind the synchronous machine is having a armature on the stator and a field on the rotor. So there are two reasons that normally for the production of the power or production of the electricity is merely normally done by the synchronous alternator, which we know that synchronous generator are also known as the alternators, and alternators are of very high capacity or high kV ratings, and since the kV rating of them are very high, at that point they are costly. So since they are costly because of the reason that the capacity is high, capacity of the total kV rating is high, at that point what happens if the normal procedure which we have seen in the induction machine, that the field coils are on the rotor, on the stator, and the armature coil on the rotor. At that point, what will happen that the armature would be running, and that is actually high voltage line, and from that the slip rings will be coming out, and the slip rings will be having the brushes also, and high voltage will be running, and the low voltage will be stationary. So that will be an additional cost to the equipment, as well as another thing would become that the insulation problem from the rotating armature will be very much difficult. Another thing would be the cooling. The cooling of the machine will not be there as sufficient as this arrangement would be giving, because this arrangement, in this arrangement the field is on the rotor, which is a less voltage coils, and whereas the armature is actually giving the output in the case of DC generator, and at that point the armature is of high capacity. The armature coil will be giving the kV rating of the machine actually. So the armature, if armature is stationary, then it will be very much beautifully insulated, and high voltage winding will be clearly taken out from the stationary armature. One more thing will come, the cooling of the armature, stationary armature, would be better done if it is on the stator rather than on the rotor. A lot of different reasons are also there behind this, but the main reason behind this is the cooling of the machine and the rating of the machine. And since the synchronous machine is already a costly machine, if it is synchronous machine is made as the induction machine is normally made, then the costing of the machine will again become very much high, and that will be out of the reach of a normal customer. So synchronous machines are normally made such that the field winding is on the rotor as well as the armature winding on the stator. One more thing comes about the construction of the machine. As we have discussed this thing that the field coils are on the rotor as well as the armature coil is on the armature coil on the stator. So the stator actually is having the three phase three different coils which are actually mechanically placed 120 degree apart from each other, so that the rotating magnetic field is produced. So it is having the three coils which are actually placed by 20 degree apart from each other. On the coming to the rotor, as we have already discussed about the silent pole type of the rotor or the dumbbell shape of the rotor, this type of rotor is known as the silent pole type. This type of rotor is known as the silent pole type, whereas the conventional rotor, which is actually round in nature, are called as the non-silent pole or the cylindrical rotor. Are also called as the cylindrical rotor. So both are having advantages and disadvantages. We can discuss them one by one. In the silent pole type, as we can see that the rotor is, the length of the rotor is high, and it is not actually uniform length. So one thing comes which is called as the speed of this silent pole is low. These are low speed, these are of low speed, and the cylindrical rotor are of the highest speed. The speed of the rotation of the silent pole is low, whereas the cylindrical rotor is high, because of the reason that the mechanical force, when it moves, the mechanical force is towards the outside. So if this rotor is made to run at a higher speed, then this rotor drag cup, this cup will not be able to sustain that much mechanical pressure, and the rotor may get damage. So they are normally used at low speed, whereas the cylindrical rotor is mechanical force on the all sides are equal, so it can be used for higher speed. So since this is working on the low speed, but so this can be having a higher large diameter. So this is having large dia. With less axial length, this will be having a small diameter and large axial length. So one can conclude this thing that the machine which is using the silent pole, which will be running at a lower speed, and the number of poles will be high in this, and the number of poles here will be less. Another thing, the height of the silent pole machine will be large, very much high. The height of the machine will be very much high, but it will be compact. So it will be compact because the axial length of the rotor is less. But here the machine will be of low length since the diameter is low, but it will be of larger axial length. So by merely looking at the machine, you can conclude that whether the machine is using a silent pole or a non-silent pole or the cylindrical rotor. One more thing comes in this non-silent pole and cylindrical rotor, that here the damper windings will be here. Whereas the damper windings, which we have already discussed, will be actually on the periphery of the cylindrical rotor. So it will be having a uniform cross section, a uniform distribution of the damper windings, whereas in the case of cylindrical pole machine, it will be having a non-uniform case of the rotor as well as the damper winding too. So one can conclude, and one more thing, that there are two types of rotors in case of synchronous machine. One is called a cylindrical pole machine, and is called a non-cylindrical pole machine. These are of low speed, these are of higher speed, these have large diameter, these are low less diameter, these are having less axial length, these are having larger axial length.